Now remember the image that we had before, tree, light going through a small pinhole, generating an image here. Now, as I said, smaller the pinhole, the less amount of light will actually pass through. So this would be a much darker image. What we want to do is open this up a little bit more so more light will go through. Again, the size of this thing is going to be important as the amount of light that goes through from the obstruction to the other side to form an image. So one of the best ways, of course, to do this is to replace this hole with a lens. So here we still have our tree, our sensor, our screen, and in place of this, we want to replace it with a lens. But before we do that, let's look at the characteristics of a lens. Here I'm just showing an example, or now I can add a lens in between the 3D scene, in this case the tree, and the sensor. One of the interesting things about a lens is that when a ray of light, a wavefront, hits it, it can be made to converge to a point. And that's what we actually want to be able to do, is we want to get all the rays of light going in and hitting this lens and then converging to a point. And then basically that would allow us to get a light as from a much bigger opening, as big as this, as opposed to just a point. But also we want to actually simulate exactly something like a point where all the light would be. So this ray of light goes through, hits the lens, and of course now is converging to the screen at this point. A ray of light from the same point here will go through the lens and converge to this point here, and that will allow us to create the top of the tree. And another one would go through the lens at this point and converge in. So all three lines are converging here, and this is how I would be able to construct just the top point of the tree here. And of course, rays of light are coming in from the entire tree and go through the whole lens to generate an image on that side. And this is how we get an inverted tree with a resulting image simulated here.